Hi, this is the second part for the displaced modifier. If you didn't watch the first part, please watch it first and then come to this video, because I will not repeat some of the things I already said in the first part. Now, in the first video, we learned about how we can derive the pulling force, the magnetic force, only by using the gizmo with three different shapes: the planar gizmo, the cylindrical gizmo, and the spherical gizmo. With these three gizmos, all the forces that comes out from them in a perpendicular manner relative to the gizmo, all these forces are identical. They have the same strength, and this strength is controlled by this parameter here. Now, in this video, we'll see how we can map a texture map or a procedural map. Here we have a texture map mapped on the gizmo, and here we have a procedural map, and where the brightness of the pixels will control the strength of each of the forces coming out from the gizmo. First, I will create a plane. I will increase the subdivision because I need a large amount of vertices to have some details. And now I will add a displace modifier. Now I will map a texture map on this gizmo. Here in image, bitmap, click none. Now, the way it works, this image here, imagine this image is stretched on this gizmo here. And since from each point on this gizmo, there is a force pulling up perpendicular to this gizmo, each force now will look down and check the pixel, the brightness of the pixel under it. And the brightness ranges from 0 total black to 255 white. This value, this brightness value, will be multiplied then by the strength to determine the strength of each of these forces to create these complex or these variant pulling strength. So I will increase the strength now, and you can see the result. The brighter colors will pull up more, the darker pulls less. We don't have total black here in this image, but some of the brightness are close to black. If I increase the subdivision here on the plane, I will have more details, like 100 by 100. Try not to exaggerate a lot with this. I will make it 60 by 60 for now. Like we saw in the first video, moving the gizmo up and down will not affect the strength because decay is zero, and if you want the distance to affect this, increase the decay, and the more you increase the decay, the influence of the distance will increase. So now if I make it like 0.01, you can see what happens. I will make it zero again. Now I will open the image in a photo editing software. I will take a brush. First, I will choose a total black, and I will create a contour like this. And something like this. And then I will save. Go back to Max. Click here and choose the image again. Now you can see this part here stays on the zero. There is no pulling happening here. And we have this gap here also. You can add a turbo smooth at the end if you like to increase the resolution, make it smoother. Of course, you can play with the gizmo. You can scale it up or down. Okay. What you can do also, you can add another displace. I will scale this, the gizmo, and move it here. I will increase the displace. Here I'm just using the gizmo, no texture, but you can also add a texture if you like to create some complex detail here. Well, I can rotate it 180 degrees. So you get the idea. I will copy this. I will remove the second displace. Here I wanna use a procedural map. So I will remove the bitmap. You can click here, remove bitmap. You can click here to make the gizmo perfectly at the same size with the geometry. So for the procedural maps, you need to click this button here. You have many procedural maps here. I will choose checker. For now, the checker has only one repetition, black and white. Now, what I can do, I can open the material editor. And drag this checker here. Make it instance so that everything I do here will affect this checker here. And for the tiling, instead of one by one, I will make it 4x4. Going back to this shape here, I will remove the second displace. Now, if I click the plane, I can use a UVW map to control the mapping of this texture map here. I will scale the gizmo. As you can see, it's not affecting the map used by the displace. What you can do if you want to use the mapping derived from the UVW map, you can click the displace, go here and choose use existing mapping. Now if you look from the top, see you have this map here and it's repeating. So basically that's it for this video. Hope you like it, and if you do, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel, and see the next video. Thank you.